You're watching Electrical Engineering Lectures channel. For more videos, please do like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications.
Hello, welcome to the new video. In the previous video, we have shown you how to use the IO pins of the device as output, and we have derived an LED. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the IO pin as input pin. So we are going to read the digital input. So what does it mean? It means that a digital signal has two levels, either high or low. So in this case, the device will act as a sink. Whenever we apply a voltage equal to the minimum detection level of the device and equal to the bias voltage, it will detect as high input. And when the voltage falls below this level, the input is zero. So we are going to read this digital signal through the microcontroller. So for this, we'll start by writing the program to read the digital input. The complete body of the program is almost the same as we have previously written for the output. So first of all, we have to include the device header file, which is against in our case is 12C671 microcontroller. Then comes the fuses. Again, we are going to use XT fuse since our oscillator frequency is 4 MHz and no watchdog timer, no protect and memory clear fuse. The next command is to include or use the 4 MHz oscillator. Then comes the definition of 3 pins A0, A1 and A2. I am going to use pin A0 as input and drive the pin A1 and A2 as output. So then comes our main function, which is void main. In this function, I've initialized all 3 pins equal to 0. So this is called the initialization. You can also write a comment alongside with this command by adding a forward to slash, that is initialization of IO pins. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to write an infinite while loop, and then I'm going to use a built-in function of PIC C compiler to read the digital input, which is input bracket. Since I'm going to use A0 as input, so I will write GP inside the bracket. So if you want to know about this command, you can select this and press F1. This will open this command into a help window. You can see here the syntax of this command, the parameters, and what this command returns. As you can see that if this input pin is low, then it will return 0, and if the input is high, then the pin will return 1. So either you can equalize this command function equal to any variable, or you can use directly this function into any conditional statement. So I'm going to use this command directly into the if statement. And what will this command do? It will check the status of the input, whether it is high or not. So check the status of input pin A0. So what will it do? If the input is high, it will make the pin A1 high. So I want to make A1 high, so I have to write GP1 here. And what if the input is low? It will make the output low. Again the same pin GP1, output low, and close the parenthesis for else, then for while, and then for our main function. So this completes the program, and this program will replicate the function of a switch. That is, whenever the input is high, the output will become high, and when the input is low, the output will become low. So let's just build this program. A hex is generated in this folder. So we'll go to the simulation to check the functionality of our program. So I've already built the schematic, and this is almost the same as we have previously built for the last program. So I'm using the PIC 12C671. I have connected a switch with pin A and not, because this is an input pin, and I will drive the LED with pin A and 1, which is in our case is the output pin. So play the simulation. Now you can see that LED is not blinking or glowing. As we close the switch, you can see that LED is now turned on, and as we open the switch, it makes the output low. So this is what we want. I have also connected a pull down resistor with this input. This is because that I don't want my input to be in the floating state when the switch is open, because a noise may cause the input to become high and will cause nuisance detection of the input. So it is a good practice to always pull down the input when your switch is open. So next thing is, I'm going to explain the phenomena of debouncing. So what is debouncing? Debouncing is that whenever you use a push button to give the input to a digital pin and want some variable to be incremented in reaction to the input. So whenever you press the button, your microcontroller will sense the input is high, and in return it will increment a variable. And when you release the button will actually take time to get from the high position to the low position. You can see that the transition from on to off will take almost 100 to 200 milliseconds. Since the clock frequency is very fast and your program is polling continuously, the variable will be incremented several hundred or thousand times during this transition period, and you don't want your variable to get incremented. So what will you do? You will insert an intentional delay in order to avoid a multiple press condition, and this is called the debouncing, to add an intentional delay to cater for the transition period of a switch. So after a debouncing delay, if the input is still high, then your variable can increment it to the next value, so it is normal. So for this, I'm going to write another program. I'll make this complete program comment and uncomment this chunk of the program, which will explain the phenomena of debouncing. So for this, I need to initialize a variable which is int16. So what I am doing here is that, again after the infinite while loop, I am going to check the input pin. If the value of the I variable is greater than 40,000, then I'll make the pin output high. So I am putting an additional delay after sensing the input. So if my input is zero, this will make the output zero. So after this time, our output will become high, and this is an intentional delay to cater the effect of debouncing. So I'll again build the program. So I'll repeat once again that what this program will do. It will sense the input, and after some time, when the variable I will be greater than 40,000, it will make the output high. If the value is less than 40,000, it will remain in the low state. So our LED will not glow if the input is high for only a short period of time. So let us simulate the program. So if I close the switch for very short time and then open it, the LED should not glow. As you can see that since the variable is less than 40,000, I have put an additional delay. So even the input is high, the LED is not glowing. But if I keep the switch for longer period of time, it will then sense the input, and after some time it will make the output high. So this is basically the effect of debouncing. So this is now for this video. So in the next video, I'm going to tell you how to use the pins as analog pins and how to read the analog values. So keep watching and stay tuned to this channel. Thank you for watching.